Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create this party planner checklist with the help of AI. It's really quick and simple, very customizable. You don't have to do a party planner. You can do any kind of checklist you want. So let's get started. So you need to go over to ChatGPT and the website is openai.com. But I'll put the link in the description below. You will have to just sign up to it, but it's completely free. And then just click try ChatGPT. And then at the bottom here, you can type anything you like. So for this one, I'm going to type party planner checklist and press enter. And the AI will then go ahead and create a checklist for you. Now, you don't have to accept this checklist if you don't want to. You can type something else in and see what comes out. Or at the end of it, you can make it regenerate. So if you're not happy, you can go to regenerate response. But let's just use this one for an example. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to click and drag across the whole checklist. And then I'm going to press Command or Control C to copy it. Or you can use this icon here that is your clipboard. Then go back to Word and go up to Paste, click on the drop down and select Keep Text Only. If you don't, it will enter into a table that doesn't really work very well with Word. So I'm just going to go ahead and customize this so it's all ready for our table. So I'm going to select the titles and then I'm going to click Bold or select the title and press Command or Control B, which will also turn it bold as well. I'm going to go ahead and do that to all of the headings. Once I've done that, I'm going to place my cursor at the end of each section and press my return key just to give me a space between all of those sections. Then I can go ahead and correct any of the spelling errors. Here in Britain, we spell things slightly differently. So you can see that the way we spell color and favors is also a little bit different as well. Okay, once you're happy with the general layout, you can change everything afterwards, but let's just go ahead and show you how to do the basics. So I'm going to click and drag across all of my text, all the way to the top. I'm going to go to Insert, Table, click on the drop down, and go down to Convert Text to Table. I'm going to accept all of the default, just one column, and then click OK. So you can see Word has now put everything into a table, which is going to save us an awful lot of time of copying and pasting. But my rows are just a little bit too narrow. So I'm going to keep the table selected. If you deselect it, just go to the top left here and click on this square and reselect the whole table. Then go to Layout and go to Height. Now I'm going to change my height to 0.7 because I think that just gives you a little bit more space. In addition to that, you can see that all of my text is towards the top of my cell and I actually want it to the center. So I'm going to select my table again, go to Layout, and you can adjust where your text lies in your cell by using one of these 9 options. I want my text to the middle left. And then the next thing I need to do is just add a column to the right to put in my checklist. So make sure the table's selected, go to Layout and go to Insert Right. And you can see we've inserted a column to the right. And then whilst that's selected, I'm going to grab this central line here, click and drag that column all the way to the right because we don't need too much space for just a checkbox. Now, if you don't want your text going over to a second line within your cell, you can always reduce the size of your text. So you can select the table, go to the Home tab, and you can go to this Reduce Font Size or Decrease Font Size tool, and you can click on it until all of your cells only have one line in. But in some respects, you will find once you've got just those one lines, the text is a little bit small. You can see here, we haven't quite got one line and the text is still on 2 lines. However, you can of course reduce the text in that cell by just changing the title or the content. So the next thing I'm going to do is enter a row above this. So I'm going to select this cell here, go to layout, and go to insert above. That means it's going to insert an entire row above. And in this column here, I can put complete. Again, that text is towards the top. So select these two cells here, go to layout, and I'm going to go to this center align tool here. And then in here, I'm going to put action. And of course, you can change the font sizes of these two if you want to. Just go to the home tab, make sure you've selected them. And you can go to this increase font size tool here and decrease font size here. Now, in order to move this table down, you'll need to put your cursor in the very top left cell and then just press the return key. And you'll see now your cursor is outside of the cell, which allows you to move the table down as much as you want to. I'm going to move the table down enough that I've got room for a title. However, I'm not going to simply put my cursor here, put it towards the center, type a title, and leave it there. I want to use all of this space here. And to do that, I'm going to use a text box. So go to insert, text box, click on the drop down and select draw text box. Click and drag out a text box. Type in my text, and then I can select it. Go to the home tab. I'm going to change this text to Melania. I'm going to also use this icon here to change it to sentence case. And then I'm going to use this increase font size tool here to make that text as big as I want. And then I'm going to choose this center text icon here as well. Now, if I move this text box around, you can see it's got a white background. And if I deselect it, you can see it's got a black border. I want to get rid of both of those. So select it, go to shape format, go to shape outline, click on this drop down and select no outline, go to shape fill, click on this drop down and select no fill. And then you'll have a completely transparent text that you can move anywhere you like. To perfectly center it, select it, go to shape format, go to align, click on the drop down and select align to center. Deselect everything by clicking away, and then you can see how your table will look. I'm going to move my table down a bit, so place my cursor just above my table and press the return key. And then I'm going to move my title down just a little bit. Perfect. Now, if you want this section here on the following page and you don't want it broken up, then all you need to do is click on this row here, which is the start of the new section. Simply go to layout and then go to split table. Click on it and you can see your cursor now is between the first and second table. And then all you need to do is to move it to the second page. Now, I'm just going to undo that for a second because I want to insert my little boxes for a digital checklist. So if you don't want to simply print this out and tick these boxes, you can use this as a digital form. So in order to do that, you have to have this developer tab here. If you don't have it, go to Word, go to Preferences, go to Ribbon and Tools, then go to Main Tabs here, then go down to the bottom and make sure this developer tab is checked here and click Save. When you come back, you can see this developer tab here. Now, this is where you can insert checkboxes, text boxes for a fillable digital form. So I'm going to make this quite simple today. I'm just going to select this cell here and I'm going to pop in a checkbox here. I'm going to take out the shading because at the moment you can see there's this gray shading. So I'm going to take out the shading. Then I'm going to go back to the layout tab and I'm going to click this center alignment tool here to center that box. I'm also going to select it by just clicking and dragging across it. I'm going to press Command or Control C to copy. And then all I'm going to do is click and drag, keep holding down the mouse, click and drag, just move over to here, click and drag all the way to this bottom cell here. And then I'm going to press Command or Control V to paste. Now you can see the boxes aren't aligned, so keep that selected, go to layout, and select the center align here. Now, once you've got all of the boxes in, you won't actually be able to use them as a digital form until you go back to the developer tab and you protect the form. So click on protect the form, and then you'll be able to just simply click on these boxes and you can see they will be checked. To uncheck them, just click on them again, and you can see they will uncheck. So that's your digital form. The slight downside to that is at the moment, I can't then edit any of this because the form is locked. So in order to go back and do any editing, then you need to go to the developer tab and then uncheck protect form. So I'm going to do a few final things to this checklist. I'm just going to change some of the table and put in my page numbers. So select the table, go to table design, and then along to this icon here. This is an icon, if you click on the drop down, where you can change the thickness of the borders around your table. So I like to choose 2.25 points. The color obviously stays black, and I want some borders around the outside. So you've got borders here, click on the drop down and you can see all the borders that you can choose, but I'm going to select outside border. And as you can see now, I've got a nice thick outside border. I'm going to select these two cells here. And again, I'm going to select the outside border because it will draw an outside border around any cells that you select. So if I selected just half of this table, it will just put an outside border around half of the table. And if you just want one cell or one row, select the row, go back. Because it's already selected the outside borders, I just have to click and then it will go to outside borders and give you that cell border there. And then I'm going to do the same with this column here. I'm just going to select the column and go back up to outside borders. If you have a space at the bottom, you can add some notes. So select this bottom cell, go to layout, and then go to insert below. So that's inserting rows below. Just click until you've matched the one on the left. If it goes over to a third page, just press Command or Control Z to go back. And you can have some additional lines at the bottom here for notes. If you want some page numbers, then simply go down to the bottom, double click. You'll be in your headers and footers. You'll notice you'll be in the headers and footers tab as well. Go to page number, click on the drop down and select page number. And then I want to align mine to the center and then click OK. And there you can see you've got your page numbers at the bottom. Double click back into the main document by clicking anywhere in the middle. And now you have your finished checklist. Once it's all finished, don't forget to go to the developer tab and click Protect Form if you want to use it as a digital form, or you can just simply print this out and check the boxes. Again, you don't have to put the boxes in if you don't want to, you can just print it out without them. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.